because we have won this
हम लोग का मूड स्पॉइल कर दिया।
आपका ही ग्रुप का था, आप पूछिए और रेट रेट क्या है करके।
फोटो को भी नहीं देखते हैं उसके बाद पूछो। हाँ रेट मत पूछना, लड़की का आधा कपड़ा नहीं देखा। सॉरी बोले से होगा, बोले तो हम लोग को कुछ नहीं होता है।
तुम लोग के वजह से ना हम लोग को ऐसा होता है।
तुम लोग के बच्चे बुढ़े हो गए, दिमाग हो गए, बीवी बच्चे हैं, तुम लोग और चाहिए क्या? चकला चुआ बोलना, रेट पूछ रहा था ना, रेट बताऊंगी तुझे। यहाँ बड़ा
just to tell you I wouldn't say a small incident, but an incident that really made us question a lot of things about a lot of people and a lot of stakeholders that are in place, and we are so much disgusted by it. Yesterday we went to Hoskas village just to chill with friends, and Hoskas village is located in Delhi. So after everything got over and after we were out of the pub, we were just waiting for a cab, and we were also waiting for one of our friend who's a guy. A group of men came towards us, and these men were mostly of age 40 to 45, or maybe like a little older men, you know, those men who are like literally
have no hair
and you know are wearing polo t-shirt with jeans. And then one guy just comes beside me. I actually thought that guy wants to get inside the car, and this did not happen outside of Hoskas village, but this happened inside, right beside where the fort is. Okay.
And it was only like 10 p.m.
yeah, it was like around 10 p.m. because of the COVID restrictions. All the pubs get closed at around like 10 a.m. okay. So what actually happened, these group of men, they came, and there was a car parked beside to us when we were like waiting for our friend. And then this guy and me, I just thought maybe this person wants to get inside the car, that's why these many people are coming. So what actually happened, this guy comes to me and asks me, rate kya hai? And I was like, what the hell? And then I started screaming and shouting and you know, saying like, bhai, tere ko kya ho gaya? Rate pooch raha hai, tere ko kya ho gaya? And my friends, they didn't even know
what was happening. I asked her what happened, she was like, rate kya hai? When we start screaming at them, they were like, run away. Like, there were nobody to help us. We even informed the nearby, like, there were a few guys. And nobody was like, there was no reaction.
Yeah, there was no reaction from people. And we were screaming and we were shouting, saying, what the hell? Why tu hamara rate kyun pooch raha hai? Bhai, tere ko kya lag raha hai? Ki hum log kya hai? Hum log sex workers. Really, like, you know, that was like a disgrace. That was like something so shitty. It's been like 2 years for me here in Delhi. She's lived here like for 5 years in Delhi. And this is something we've never faced right now. And okay, we faced that thing. Okay, he asked for the rate. Then we went to the police, and the police was also coming by. We said, you know, police ji, aisa aisa ho gaya. Police also went smiling. I mean, like, he's supposed to be the stakeholder, the primary stakeholder. Wherein, if something happens to the public, they are supposed to take action. And then nothing happened, and the police just went smiling. Then further we went, we met those people again, and they were acting as if, like, you know, they didn't know us, they didn't see us, and then, you know, they were hiding their faces in shame. And then we made this video. Okay. Even after this thing, we thought, like, you know, we being friends and, you know, we just wanted to take a day off and we just wanted to go away from all these hectic work life or hectic schedule that we have. We thought, like, let's go to another place. Even while going to another place, the police also asked my friends.
Okay, let me tell you, like, we and she was talking on phone and me and my sister, we were going in. There was a policeman. He asked, like, where are you going? So we said that we are just going to this restaurant, like, for eat. And he was like, oh, so not restaurant, it's a pub, but we went there just to eat because that's a restaurant as well and bar as well. So what happened, like, we told him we are just going to eat there, like, we are not going, I know it's about to be closed, but we are just going to eat. So policeman told me, like, are you a dancer? No, I'm not a dancer. Like, he was like, just be honest, I won't do anything, are you a dancer? And I was like, no, we are not dancer, we are students here, like, we are not here for dancing and all. And I told him, like, do you even dance in your police station? How can you say like that? And after that, when I said, I'll make a video, wait, and he just ran away.
I mean, like, this, all of these things happened. It was not even, like, 3 a.m. in the morning. It was not even, like, 4 a.m.
It's not even 12.
Yeah, it was not even 12. It was, like, around 11:30. I mean, most of the people who come from Safdarjung, who live in South Delhi, they know that, you know, 11:30, like 11 o'clock, most of the eatery stores get shut. And, you know, by 12, like, otherwise, if there is no COVID, by, like, 1 o'clock, all these pubs, they get shut. I mean, where is the safety? Where's the thing out here? We cannot trust people. We cannot trust anybody on the street. Even if the stakeholder who's to be trusted, which is the police, are just smiling and smirking away, what are we supposed to do? What are women supposed to do? There are only, like, passerbys who are just looking and just who are so ready to make videos, but not even take action, not even, like, you know, there is any, no guy, no girl out there just to, you know, just to come in between and, you know, just to help us out. And believe me, this is not the first time something like this has happened with other people in Delhi. I know a lot of more tragic, more scarier stuff have happened. For example, my friend has got hit by a car in Hoskas village and I thought she died. So these kind of incidences have happened. How can we ensure that we are safe on the streets? I mean, like, we are just normal people. Imagine the amount of harassment the sex workers might be facing. Harassment these people who earn their living by working as a sex worker, they must be facing through. Like, how can we even make this streets a safer place? And believe me, it's not about the time. You guys might be thinking, you know, we were at the wrong time, at the wrong place, we were wearing a wrong type of dresses. You know, people come up with all sorts of things, you know, trying to victimize women, especially trying to say a lot of things. But I'm sorry, bro, if you're thinking this way, I am really, really, really sorry. It's all about people's mentality. There's nothing to do with the time or to do with the dresses that we wear. I appeal all of you, if you watch this video, please share as much as you can. These people might be in your neighborhood. These people might be like somebody that you know. So that let's just share and, you know, let us be aware of all these things that are happening. And believe me, I've stayed in Calcutta, I've stayed in Bombay, I've stayed in Pune, I've stayed in a lot of metropolitan cities. These things haven't happened to me. I've actually worked in red light areas, which is Kamatipura in Mumbai as a social worker. And believe me, there are so many people out there, but nothing happened. I mean, like, but what are the streets of Delhi like? What's happening in the streets of Delhi? I mean, like, this is seriously something to be thought upon.
And lastly, we would like to say that we are not here to gain any kind of sympathy or any kind of publicity, these, that. And we just want you guys to share this video so that we can expose those morons. And
then maybe, like, those people...
So they might get caught by this video. We just want you people to just share this video and... I have a request, do not spam us with a DM. We are not here to gain any kind of sympathy. We just want to expose those people.
Because we felt really sad and these things are like something which really, it's sad. Only the people who faced it would understand. And Anyways, we would thank you for listening. Thank you guys for listening to these things, and till then, bye.